All right, in the last video, we looked at how to convert entire radicals into mixed format, being 3 root 5, for example, with a coefficient out in front of the radical. This time, we're going to look at how to go from a mixed radical back to an entire. So let's start with a mixed radical, 3 root 5. How do we get that into an entire radical format? We want to make sure you get this 3 underneath the radical symbol so there are no coefficients out front. We have to do a little bit of trickery here, though. In order to get that number back underneath, we've got to play around with that 3 a little bit. I'm going to rewrite this number. I'm going to take that 3, I'm going to square it, and I'm going to take the square root of it. Squaring and taking the square root are opposite functions, so that's not going to change the number at all. If I punch this in on my calculator, square root of 3 squared, I'm going to end up with 3. I haven't changed that there. And I'm going to leave my square root of 5 there. So I haven't changed anything, I've just rewritten that 3 squared. Next step, I'm going to work out that 3 squared as being 9. So now I've got the square root of 9 times the square root of 5. Now, I can combine those both under one radical. 9 times 5. And lastly, I can work out what 9 times 5 is, square root of 45. And if you check 3 root 5 on your calculator, and if you check square root of 45, you'll find that numerically they are the same. Let's try one more here. How about 4 root 5? Well, let's do the same thing. Take that 4, rewrite it as the square root of 4 squared times root 5. I don't know why I happened to pick root 5 again. Anyway, it's just a simple number to work with. Square root of 4 squared. Same thing as square root of 16 times root 5. Combine them both under one radical. Work out what 16 times 5 is, and we get the square root of 80. So you can see, take a quick look here at what we did. We go through a few steps here, the squaring and square rooting, simplifying what the square is, putting them both on the same radical, and then combining. Let's see if we can simplify that a little bit, though. I'm trying to take this 3, or the 4 here, I'm trying to move it underneath the radical. When I do that, I can take that coefficient, this 3 here, when I move it across the radical, I need to square it. When it becomes squared, it becomes a 9, and then I multiply that 9 by the 5. When I take this 4 and it crosses underneath the radical symbol here, I square it. It becomes a 16. I end up with 16 times 5 and root 80. So by putting the coefficient back into the radical, converting it into entire, I'm basically taking the coefficient, squaring it, and then multiplying by what's already underneath the radical. Let's try one more, it's just a little bit trickier. Let's not use any numbers this time. Let's do x times the square root of x. Alright, a little bit fancy this time. Now, let's go through the same steps we did before. Take that x that's out front, square it, and take the square root of it. And it's still being multiplied by the root x from the 4. Now I've got root x squared times root x, which I can combine under the same radical, root x squared times x, and x squared times x is x cubed, adding the coefficient, or adding the exponents there. So x root x becomes root x cubed. That's how we convert mixed radicals into entire radical format.